Able to create a jittered scatter plot. So we start by jittering our variables. We go to transform, compute, choose the variable we want, and we want to take the variable education and we want to add to that some random numbers to just send them off kilter a little bit. So we scroll down this list of the function group list till we find random numbers. Once we click that, we get a list of all the different functions that are under the random number function group. And we want RV uniform, and once we click on that, we get a little explanation over here. If that's the one we want, we click it so that it goes up into that box. And so we're adding to education, we're adding random numbers anywhere between negative 0.5 and positive 0.5. So we type in negative 0.5, it replaces that question mark. Get rid of that question mark, we have to delete it, and type in positive 0.5, which of course we don't need the positive sign. And we need the new variable name, and we typically call it J whatever. So we type in J, E-D-U-C, so it's the same variable name with just a J in the beginning. That way we know it's a jittered variable. We can never use a jittered variable in any of our statistical runs, only for scatter plots. And we say OK. And then we go through the process all again for mom's education. So we have to find ma, E-D-U-C. And we can get rid of regular EDC. We click Ma EDUC over, and we change this so this says J Ma EDUC. So the exact same variable name in both places, but with the J on the new variable name. The target is our new variable name. Say OK again, and then we go way down here to the very bottom to our taskbar to click back over to our data view, to our data set. We scroll all the way to the end. And we see our two new variables here, JEDUC and MAEDUC. There will be decimal points in here, but you can't see it because we have our default with no decimals. So if I double click on the heading right here, it will take me down here to the variable view for that variable. And I can change the decimals, like put the decimals up a couple. Then I go back down to the bottom, click on the data view tab at the bottom left. And I can see that the variables now show decimal places. The next step is to create the graph. So we go to graphs, chart builder. And we want a scatter plot. And so when we click on that, of course, it gives us all the choices. And we just take the first choice and we drag it right up here to our little previewer pane. And we have to drag the variables that we want in here. And our two variables are the J variables. So we're going to drag JEDUC, that's the respondent's education jittered, and JMAEDUC, mother's education, we're going to drag it down there. And then we just say OK. And it takes a few minutes to think about things. And we scroll down once the graph comes up, and there's the graph right there.